Very good morning, my dear friends. I wish you all very good morning and welcome to my channel, Mechanical Engineering Lecture Series, and myself, Dr. M.H. Annaya, former Professor of Mechanical Engineering at M.S. Ramaya Institute of Technology, Bangalore, and presently Vice Principal at Saptagiri College of Engineering, Bangalore. Friends, in today's session, we are going to learn about design of a butt joint which is made using two cover plates or butt strap of unequal width. Friends, if we just go through the problem, it runs like this. Design a double riveted butt joint. When you say butt joint, the plates are butt against each other. Cover plates are made use with two cover plates of unequal width. The cover plate, one of the cover plates will have lesser width compared to the other. And that I have shown here by means of a sketch. This is plate number one, plate number two. They are to be riveted using a triple riveted, you will say. Sorry, this is not triple riveted. This is a triple riveted because you find here three rows of rivet. Hence, it is a triple riveted butt joint with two cover plates. I have shown this cover plate as CP1 and this is CP2. And these two plates to be joined by butt joint have a thickness of 25 mm. The material strength, that is the strength of the plate and that of the rivets, are given here very clearly. So you will have to find out the parameters like diameter, various pitches, thickness of the cover plates, the margin to be provided, etc., including the efficiency of the joint. Friends, basically when we start with this problem, when you have a problem on this, any of these riveted joint, you will have to open the chapter on riveted joint and you will find a very big table running through 3 to 4 pages in which you find lot of information about every possible type of riveted joint, both on the lap type and also on the butt type. Here you have given a problem, it is a triple riveted joint using two cover plates of unequal width. If you refer, go through that, you will be able to find a joint like this. And here I have shown only the arrangement of rivet on only one plate. This I have shown here. And this is how it looks when you take a section along one. If you take a section, SS, or say here, if you take a section, cut it open, this is how the rivet arrangement will look. Friends, before we calculate the various values of pitches, let's first of all see the value of the thickness of the plates to be riveted, compare it with the standard value small d, and then find out what is the diameter of the rivet. Friends, here I'm going to just rub this time being to accommodate all these calculations. Friends, this step number one, we have to find out the diameter of the rivet small d. I told you the diameter of the rivet in any of these riveted joints depends on the thickness of the plates to be riveted, and hence here we have thickness h is equal to 25 mm, which is greater than 8 mm, the standard size, and hence we can straight away calculate the value of this diameter of the rivet as 0.2 times small h, where d and h, the diameter and the thickness of the plate, are in meter. And hence, if I substitute the value, you get 0.2 into root of h. H is 25 mm divided by 1000 to convert that to millimeter. So, sorry, this comes in meter, and this works out to 0.03162 meter. And when converted to millimeter, this will be 31.62 mm. So the diameter of the rivet to rivet these two plates of thickness 25 mm He is 31.62 mm. Friends, after getting this value, the value you obtain by calculation may not be a standard value of the rivet that is available in the market, and hence we are going to refer to the table and find out the diameter, the standard size available. So corresponding to this, when you refer to the table of standard size, we have the diameter D is equal to 33 mm, and the corresponding diameter of the hole to be drilled in the plate is equal to 34.5 mm. So this is a very important step. So friends, in all the previous sessions and also in this session, we are taking the thickness of the plates always equal to 8 mm or more than that. So one of you might ask me a question, sir, what happens if the thickness of the plate to be riveted is lesser than 8 mm? Suppose say the thickness of the plate to be connected is 7 mm. Friends, in such cases, we are going to equate the shear resistance of the rivets to the crushing resistance of the plates or the rivets. So for example, in any of these, you have a value from the table, you have the value from the table, substitute, equate them, and you are going to get the value of the diameter of the rivet. So we are not going to use the equation to find out that. So once again, to remind you, whenever the thickness of the plates to be riveted is lesser than 8 mm, whether the joint is a lap joint or a butt joint with any type of arrangement of rivets or the rows of rivets, you'll have to equate the resistance offered by the rivets for shearing in one pitch length to that of the resistance to crushing given by FC. The equations are available. You have to make proper substitution, get the value of D. Friends, after finding out the standard size of the rivet required and the hole to be drilled in the plate, let us move to the second step, namely finding out the various pitches, that is longitudinal pitch P, transverse pitch PT, the margin, the thickness of the cover plates H1 and H2. So these are the things we find out in the second step. Now let us start with the calculation of this P to find out this longitudinal pitch, that is the distance between any of these two adjacent rivets along any row. This is longitudinal pitch, this is longitudinal pitch, this is also longitudinal pitch. We are going to equate the resistance offered by the rivets to shearing in one of the pitch length to that of the strength of the perforated plate. So I am going to equate F tau, the shear resistance of the rivets, to the strength of the perforated plate, F theta dash. Perforated plate means the plates in which the holes are drilled to accommodate the rivets. So here friends, this F tau value, F theta dash are all available in the data handbook. So the general formula is I pi d square by 4 into tau, that is equal to P minus D into H into sigma theta. So these are the two equalities, F tau and F theta. Friends, here when I say I, if it is a lap joint, it is only I1. If it is a butt joint with two cover plates, I is just I1, because in lap joints and butt joints with single cover plate, no rivet fails by double shear. Hence, in these two cases, I1 will be there and I2 is zero. And in case of butt joints made using cover plates of equal width, there will be only the rivets failing by double shear, no rivet fails by single shear. And hence, in such butt joints, only I2 will be there and I1 is zero. And in this particular special type, where the joint is made using two cover plates of unequal width. As I have shown here, there will be some number of rivets in a row failing by single shear and some number of rivets failing by double shear. If you take our problem under consideration, see friends, this row 1 will have rivets failing only by single shear. So here this gets sheared here and there is only one. So in one pitch length you have got half place of one rivet failing by single shear. Friends, if you consider the second row, you see the rivets get sheared at two cross sections, each having area pi d square by 4. So in row 2, half place half, there will be one rivet which undergoes double shear. Similarly here, the third row also, you have these two, this rivet failing under double shear, because there are two cross sectional areas of the same rivet which offer resistance to shear, and hence you will have half place half is also 1. That is to say here, in row 1, that is under single shear, I will say I1 is equal to 1 in the first row. In the second row is only I2, I2 is equal to 1. In the third row is again rivet is failing by double shear, so I2 in the third row, it is 1. I can say this is in row 1, this is in row 2, and this is in row 3. Friends, you can say the whole system of rivets, you have got total I1 is equal to 1 and I2 is equal to 1 plus 1, these two. So there are totally 3 rivets, 1 failing under single shear, the remaining 2 in row number 2 and 3 failing by double shear. So friends, I am going to substitute these values and find out the longitudinal pitch. So here you have got this I. So I is I1 plus I2. I1 is 1. I2 is equal to 2. That is to be multiplied by 1.875. Because we are considering the shear consideration, pi d square by 4. Pi by 4. Diameter we have found out as 33 mm. So 33 square multiplied by shear strength of the rivet is 60. That is equal to P minus T, P minus 33 multiplied by H. H is equal to 25 sigma theta, 85, sorry, this is 85. And if you calculate, the value of this P works out to 147.71 millimeter. That is the value of the longitudinal pitch. Friends, on the same lines, let us refer to the data handbook and this longitude transverse pitch PT. Since the arrangement of the rivets is chain, this is going to be 2D, 2 into D, that is 2 into 33, that is equal to 66 millimeter. Then the margin is M, 1.5D, 1.5 times 33, that is 33 plus 16.5, that is 49.5 mm. Then H1 and H2, H1 is the thickness of the small wider plate, less wider plate, that is 0.625H, and this H2, the thickness of the wider cover plate is 0.75H. H is equal to 25, and if you substitute these values, you get them as 15.625, and this little more, 18.75 mm. Friends, you are able to find out all the other parameters, pitch, thickness of the cover plate, margin, etc. Finally, friends, we are left with the calculation of the efficiency of the joint. So you know very well there are three efficiencies, namely the plate efficiency, eta p, the rivet efficiency, eta r, and The last one is the efficiency in crushing. So let's calculate these one by one. A, the plate efficiency eta P is given by eta P is equal to P minus D by P multiplied by 100. So you know P, you know D, substitute and this works out to 77.6589%. And similarly, you have got this eta R. This value is available in the data handbook. The equation is works out to be 77.6593. Finally, the efficiency in crushing works out to 86.74%. So these are the three efficiencies you have got. And friends, the least of these three values of the efficiencies is the efficiency of the joint. Friends, you can say here this is 77.6589, and I am very sure this is the least of all these three values. And hence I say the efficiency of the joint is 77.6589%, and the mode of failure of the riveted joint is by tearing of the plate, because eta P is the least. Friends, I hope you are totally convinced with the presentation I have made on the design of this butt joint made using cover plates of unequal width, wherein you find the rivets failing both in single and double shear. Friends, if you find this particular channel, Mechanical Engineering Lecture Series, created by a professor having 4 decades plus years of teaching experience in teaching machine design and engineering graphics, and if you find this really useful to the student community, please subscribe to my channel, share the information with all your friends. And your sharing and your subscription will help me to work out or to create more and more such videos which are going to be of immense use to the student and the teaching community. Thank you, my dear friends, for watching my YouTube channel, and have a wonderful day. And myself, Dr. M.H. Annaya, signing off.